Hello and welcome to AEA's Art Channel. My name is Ilkjan Wiersma, and today I'd like to share with you how I paint hairs. And before I do that, I'd like to explain that I only use oil paints when I'm doing portraits because of the blending time we have in oils, and we do have a bit of blending time with acrylics, but it goes way faster because of the drying time. And the oils dry overnight because I'm using a liquid that will speed up the drying time, but it gives me enough time to blend in where needed. But sometimes we don't want to blend too much because we want to make more details. And if your paint is wet, you are not always able to make those details, at least if you paint the way I do. So therefore, I like to layer in oils, and that is what I'm going to talk about today, and especially on hair. And so I thought it would be fun to share this particularly subject of hair, and I did talk about it a little bit when I did a full tutorial on this portrait, and I will have a link pop up by now, so you can check that out. And I noticed there. Also there in the intro that I'm going to pick a few subjects out of this painting to talk about a little bit more. And today is the hair, obviously, because I think there is much more to talk about than I have time for in the just the regular tutorial. So therefore, today it's only about her hair. And I started already out with just only the first layers. And now I'm building up those layers, and as you can see, I'm showing it in real time because the tutorials are sped up quite a lot. So therefore, some people think that I paint very quickly, but I don't. I just take my time, and now you can see it how long it takes and how it. I try to show you how I built up. And like I said, I started out with just a base layer, filling in. Approximately where the hair should go, and now I'm trying to create shapes. And because of this is not a commission, so I don't have to be very exact, I try to work with the shapes I already have created on my canvas by putting in the first layer, and I try to pick up those shapes and make them a bit more visible. So I can do that because it's not a commission, so I don't have to be very exact. But I have those shapes already there, so why not use them? And I'm building up a few layers over the background now, but the most of those I do later on because those are the highlights. So I'm just blocking in the background and then building up my shapes. And as you can see, I'm really taking my time. This is in real time, and I'm just building up. And I try to work from dark to light. So therefore, I start with a very dark base layer. And most of the times, I'm using that same color and just only make it a bit lighter, then blocking in again, making it lighter, blocking in again, and so forth. So I'm doing as much blocking in that way, just as long as I like it. So it's depending on the painting, sometimes I use a 3 to 4 layers, but for this girl I think I used about 8 or 9, maybe even more, but quite a lot of layers. And that is also because there was a lot of hair visible in this painting. So I think this for this particular painting, it was the it took me the longest time to finish that hair in comparison to the other portraits that I did, because like I said, there was a lot of hair visible in this painting, and also it is a bit longer hair. And also, like I said, I work with the shapes that I already created there, basically by accident, but I'm reworking them. I'm going to use them because they are already there. But like I said, if you do a commission, this is not the most practical way, because you have to be much more exactly with the hairs also if you do a commission. So therefore, if I did a commission, I would really watch my different shapes, my clumps of hair, even more than I did here. And as you can see, I'm just building up. This is not looking very pretty at this moment, but I need that texture. I really need that texture and those clumps of hair. I don't do any individual hairs at this stage, only a few on the end of this painting. So therefore I'm making clumps of hair, because that does make it look very much more realistic than that you try to do all the hairs almost individually, because that will give you a very strange looking hair. And yeah, I try to make it work by, like I said, painting clumps of hair as I see them in the reference photo. And just building up. Here you can see it start to look a little bit like hair, but even though as at this moment I didn't paint any individually hair, I just used clumps of hair, and therefore I like to use different brushes. And this brush at the moment is a you don't see it now, but the brush that I was using is a Teclon Bristol brush, so a very cheap one, but it works very well, so why not use those cheap ones. I don't have very expensive brushes anyway, but yeah, this one works very well. And sometimes I'm using a round brush to get rid of my brush strokes, because sometimes I leave a little bit too much brush strokes that will make it too rough. So therefore I like to use a rougher brush and slowly go over the paint that I already painted on to soften out my brush strokes. And I'm, like I said, I'm really watching my reference photo, even though I'm working with clumps of hair that I created by accident. I just want to watch the direction of the hair, how it goes, and which, like I said, which direction, and build from there. Even though I'm a little bit off here and there, I just try to get that movement in the hair by really watching where exactly is that movement going on in this painting. And I try to copy that, and that makes it appear way more realistic at the end. And now we are a few steps further in the painting, I think about five or six layers, and now I'm building up a little a bit smaller clumps of hairs. I have already in a few single hairs, those highlighted hairs. Sometimes I do that because then it's for me it's a bit easier to adjust the clumps of hair where they are, for example, going in a little bit in the wrong direction. It's a little bit easier for me to see then when I'm putting in a few highlights. I will glaze over them, and then later on I will pull them back by just painting over them again. But yeah, that's also a little bit personal. Some people only do the highlights really at the end, but like I said, sometimes I'm painting in a few to make it a little bit easier for myself. And now I'm using a liner brush. This is the number 4. It's for a liner brush quite thick, but I making those little clumps of hair, and therefore this brush is very, very useful. And the bristles are not bending that much, so I have quite a lot of control with a little bit stiffer liner brush. There are quite a lot of different brands of liner brushes, and I have quite a lot of them just to test them out. And most of the times I'm using the bit more stiffer ones. Like I said, I have a bit more control how my brush strokes should go with those stiffer brushes. Stiffer Bristol brushes, I should say, because it's all about the bristles of the brush, how stiff they are or how soft. And yeah, it's this one is working really well. Yeah, this one is from America, from Hobby Lobby. I ordered a few years ago some of them to test them out, and I really like them. But in Europe you can also find some liner brushes who are a bit stiffer. Once again, as you can see how slowly I'm building up and building up. That is very important. When I started painting, I tried to skip some parts because it takes so much time. But yeah, I did regret it in the end, because if the hair is not as detailed as, for example, her face or her eyes, it just is not going to look right. If you go for photorealism, of course.
because sometimes it can be very nice to have something in focus, for example, around her head, her hairs who are falling on her head, and slowly go into less detail when you are going to paint the upper parts and the last sections or from the hair who are going into the background. Sometimes it's nicer to let them not show up as a very as well as I'm doing with the detailed portions. But yeah, that's just depending on your style and what you want to accomplish, of course. But I like to try to give it this quite a realistic look, and therefore I'm taking my time and blocking in my hairs. And the nicest thing with oil paint is that if you have something, some clump of hair blocked in and you don't like it, you can easily take that paint off with a old t-shirt, for example, or with a old tissue, and I think it's the fiber that I'm using, not the regular Bounty, for example. I use those for acrylic paints, but for oils I like the more fiber tissues, and those are working very well to get paint off your canvas. So if you try portraits, or you just try them for maybe with acrylic paint and you have a really hard time, you may switch to oils because you have a lot more time to get those details in, because the paint is staying much longer wet, so you can rework it, or you can even get it completely off your canvas again. And when I started painting, I just started out with acrylics. For some reason I thought acrylics would be easier, but to be honest, I think the oil paints are easier to start with, just my personal opinion. But because of the drying time, you have way more time to adjust your brush strokes, your details, not only for hairs, but for everything in painting, for example, for animals or whatever you are painting. You have way more time to correct yourself, and therefore, especially for beginners, it is way easier to start with oils. Yeah, just have to get used to the cleaning process. That is what was holding me back from starting with oils, but yeah, it's just you have to get the hang of it. It's not that difficult. For acrylics you use water, and for oils I like to use turpentine. I have the odorless, because otherwise I get a really much headaches because of the smell. It's really, really not nice to work with, and also it's toxic, so therefore I like to switch to the odorless. Also toxic, of course, but you don't have the ridiculous smell, because it's really horrible. And yeah, the cleaning process is quite much the same. And once again, I'm slowly building up and making a few hairs there. Some are a little bit too thick, and therefore I like to use a Q-tip to get some paint off the painting again. I don't know if I included that for this tutorial at this moment, but if you have a Q-tip, you can easily also get some paint off your canvas again. So if you have a few highlights, a few individually hairs who are came out a little too thick, you can easily adjust it by using a Q-tip. And I'm still working with a liner brush, but I switched to the number 2. Because that one is a little bit thinner, and therefore it makes it easier for me to get those little highlights in. And once again I have more control because of the bristles, because they are a bit stiffer, but also now I have more control because this lighter brush is thinner than the number 4. The number 4, it is doable to get very thin lines, but yeah, it's a bit harder, so therefore I like to switch to the number 2. And now it's getting somewhere, so this is a stage that I really like, and it's the stage where everything starts to falling into place. Hairs are showing up slowly, but even more and more and more, and like I said, it is so nice when you put all those time and that effort in, it is falling into place. And yeah, that is a really, really wonderful to experience, if you ask me. And also Yeah, I could say, especially when you have those nice layers in, you have that almost three-dimensional feeling in your painting, and you start glazing and you get those colors work with one another and also the shapes. Yeah, that's really, really nice to see starting to fall in place on your canvas. It's really, really working well, and it's also, first you have to go through that ugly stages, and every time I have a period that I really don't like my painting, but I have to motivate myself to go through that state, because we have to go through that state to get to this, where we have all the details into place and everything is falling into place as it should. But yeah, sometimes that can be very hard. And as you can see here, now I'm glazing, and when I'm glazing I use the Liquim from Winsor & Newton. I'm thinning out my paint, and I'm just glazing that color over my previously layers. And in the beginning I also glaze sometimes. I've used just a single color for most of the, basically every single detail that I did, or every single brush strokes that I put in. I don't have that much detail going on in the beginning, of course, but yeah. And now I'm switching between colors. You cannot see that because I didn't film my my palette, but I every time I switch a little bit in color, it is not that noticeable at this moment, but I like to switch in a bit darker and a bit lighter colors. And for, of course, for this, because she has that beautiful red hair, I stayed, of course, in those tones, those different red tones. And therefore I like to use the Pixel, for example, or any Photoshop to get in the color pickle tool and pick up my colors, so I have a general idea which color I need to use for this hair. And like I said, I try to switch in darker and lighter colors. That is very important. Don't use too much of the same color. And I did make those mistakes very often in the beginning, that I found it did look so nice that I try and I stuck with the same color over and over again. But it's not handy. You have to use for my opinion, use quite a lot different colors. It makes it much more realistic. And here I showing it a little bit more up close what I'm using by glazing. Can you see that, how nice the color is changing? It's falling into place, because I'm glazing over the darker and lighter portions with the same color, but the color shows up a bit different, but it brings those different shapes together, and that is so important, but also so nice to do. Like I said, you have all that effort in all those different shapes, and now everything is falling to place. It just looks so more realistic than it did before. And now I'm using the side of this brush. This is a filbert, a round filbert brush. I'm just using the tip and the side of the brush, so I can more control where I'm glazing and where I'm not glazing. And on those biggest portions is here, I'm just using the whole brush, and then I'm going to the side because I want to have not the paint over the whole painting, over the whole hair of the whole section, but I'm just building up and using that point of the brush. And now I'm going back for some new paint, new glaze, and I think this one is a little bit darker, I think, than before. But like I said, I switch a lot between different tones of colors, a little bit darker, a little bit lighter, and that works very well. I don't try to use the same color over and over again. You see how nice that hair looks now. It's really starting to be one part of this painting, which is very, very nice. And here I have another liner brush. This one is you can order in Europe, and it has also a little bit stiffer bristles, not as stiff as the other ones, but enough to give to have quite some control. And I think this one is a number one or number two. And now I'm just putting in those teeny tiny little details, some highlights, some parts where the light is hitting those hairs or are standing out quite a bit, I'm filling in those with this lighter brush. Just touching the canvas. Don't push too hard, because then your bristles will start to spread over your canvas and you are making thicker lines. So just barely let that brush touch your canvas, and you can make very teeny tiny little details, and those look so nice. And this is how it looks when it's all completed. It is very, very different than in the beginning of this tutorial, as you can see. And the key to work after create this is just, like I said, building up, taking your time, and especially in oils, let it dry in time. I just edit this tutorial in one part, of course, but I have several nights in between those layers to let dry that paint. Because if I'm going to layer on top of another layer, I have to be sure that that under layer is dry. Otherwise, I'm mixing in those colors again. So therefore, that is the key when you are painting in oils. You need to know when to stop. Don't make mud, just stop in time and let it rest, let it dry, and come back another day.
So, and as usual, if you like this, or if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below this video. And maybe you have another technique or something to share, also feel free to put it in the video description, because I think it's very important, or very nice also, to share as much information that that we have, because that is a way that we can help each other learning and trying out new things, and every time I get a little bit better at the things we do at the subject that we paint, and especially for portraits. Portraits is for me the most difficult thing to paint, and therefore I came up with a plan to make a few more portraits than I normally do. So I'm working on a project that will include 12 portraits of children with from different cultures. It's also because there is a feeling, a meaning behind that project, but I will talk about it a lot more when it is all finished. And it isn't, because this is number 5, so I have a few to go, but yeah, I like the practice and to challenge myself to practice. And once in a while I have a commission, so I do also portraits in a commission, but I thought it would be nice to do a little bit more practice, well, quite a little bit more, but a little bit more practice on the portraits. So once again, I'd like to share that, and if you have something to share, please leave that in the comment section so we can all read that. And for now, thank you for watching. If you like, you can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and my own website. And of course, if you like, please give it a thumbs up. And also, if you like, please subscribe to my channel. For those who are new here, and also for the for you who are sticking with me by subscribing, thank you very, very much. I really like it. So please be welcome for those who are new here. So that was it for today. I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye bye!